Roger, come on up. Ray, I'll be you, Ray.
Oh.
Yeah, well, young. Now we got told it. How about the youngest? I guess that's you, Brother Jerry. You're very young, yeah.
I ain't young.
Now, Ray, please step in to the church. That's Father's Day.
Thank you, sir.
And Jerry, you're young, that's Father's Day.
Thank you.
Hope to have many more, man. But the women got fired, she didn't get this little bit of money.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Happy Father's Day to all of our fathers. Very special day. Amen. I hope and pray that your kids will get out and do something with you today. Before I get into the message, I want to let everybody know that we had our phone number change this week. We got away with my cell phone. Got a house phone, they wouldn't let me have the same number, so if you got something to write on, it's 828-342-8823. I'm on.
What'd you say? 8283 what?
342.
342? Okay. Second. 8823?
Yep. I want to talk to you this morning on the day of the Lord. In all my life, I thought the day of the Lord was the day he returned to his children. According to the Bible, I was wrong. But when I got to studying, it ain't got nothing to do with the resurrection. The day of the Lord is the end of time, as we know. The end of earth. The day that he destroys the earth. Destroys Satan. And that really got me for all my life. I thought the day of the Lord was when he returned to his kingdom. Now that may be the same day. I'm not going to say that. Because I believe that he's going to come before the tribulation. But that don't mean that I'm right on that. I don't know when he's going to return, but I know he's going to. The Bible says even the angels in heaven. Jesus knows when he's going to return. And I know it's going to be soon. Because, like I've said so many times, in the shape this world is in, it can't be very much longer. If you would turn with me in the book of 2 Peter. Chapter 3.
chapter 3?
Yep.
We'll start in verse 10. And the Bible tells us, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Seeing then that all these things be dissolved, what manner of persons ought you to be, all in holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heavens and a new earth wherein dwelleth righteousness. All right, let's turn over to Isaiah. Chapter 2, verse 12. For the day of the Lord of hosts shall be upon everyone that is proud and lofty, and upon everyone that is lifted up, and he shall be brought low. That we'll turn over to Ezekiel. Chapter 13, verse 5. Ye have not gone up into the gaps, neither made up for the hedge of the house of Israel, to stand in the battle in the day of the Lord. Book of Joel, verse chapter 2, verse 1. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. First Thessalonians chapter 5. For yourself know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. Fathers, we come to you this morning, Lord. We just thank you, God, for what you've shown us this week and this message, God. We pray, Lord, that we bring it out as only you would have us to, God. Father, I just pray that you would bless it. May it be a help to somebody. And I'll give you the honor and praise and glory to God in Jesus' sweet name. Amen. There was one scripture that I read, and I can't remember what was that. I forgot to mark it. It tells us that the day of the Lord is going to be a terrible day. It's going to be a terrible day for the wild. Because after that day, there'll be no more chances. God deals with us, some of us on a daily basis.
God has always taken in our hearts to accept the Lord Jesus Christ. Whether we accept him or not, that's our choice. God don't say that you have to accept me. And he don't say that you have to reject me. It's our own free choice whether we accept Jesus Christ as our Savior. And on that last day, there won't be any more death. So the next time God tugs at your heart, I plead with you. If you don't know him as your personal Savior, there is no time like the present to accept Jesus. If he's tugging at your heart today, I beg you, plead with you, please accept Jesus Christ as your Savior. Because the day is going to come when there will be no more chances. Why anyone would want to reject Jesus Christ as your Savior? Reject the blessings that he has to offer. Reject eternal life with Jesus and all the saints, and choose a life of eternal damnation in hell. You know, a lot of people think hell's like you're gonna go, you're gonna burn up. Hell is just like heaven. Hell never ends. Anybody here ever burn their hand? You know how that feels. It hurts. It might bring a few words out that we normally don't say. When you burn your hand, it hurts. But that hurt is nothing. Or hell is going to do. Imagine having your whole body burned and tortured in that severe pain. Never, ever going to go away. Day after day, year after year, decade after decade, it's still going to hurt. There's no water in hell. I've seen cartoons about how people's in hell, and they're sitting at a table, drinking coffee. And then somebody says, "In breaks over, go back to the pit." There ain't gonna be no days like that. There ain't gonna be no breaks. There ain't gonna be no water. There ain't gonna be no coffee. There is nothing there but eternal damnation. Burning in the lake of fire forevermore. Why would anybody choose that? Oh, having eternal life with Jesus. Where there's no more pain, no more sorrow, no more tears. No more days when you can't hear, man. No more days when you
take your glasses off and can't see nothing. You ain't gonna need them. Having a perfect body means perfect vision, perfect hearing. No more medical ailments. No more Alzheimer's. No more cancer. Having eternal life with Jesus Christ, being in perfect peace forever. There's no end to heaven, just like there's no end to hell. But what are we going to choose? There's either heaven or hell. If we don't accept the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior, we're doomed for hell. God don't put us in hell. We do. I reject Jesus Christ as our Savior. The day of the Lord is going to be a day of terror like we've never seen before. God is going to destroy Satan and all his demons. God is going to destroy this earth, so that he can rebuild it for our millennial land. The first 1,000 years is going to be on earth, but it's not going to be the earth that we know. It's going to be a new earth. God's building a new heaven. And that new heaven will be finished on the day of the Lord. That's what the Bible says. We have that choice. We can either serve God on earth and enjoy the benefits of serving God. Enjoy the blessings. Or we can choose hell and doom ourselves to eternal damnation forever and ever. God. I chose God a long time ago. I'm reaping the blessing that he gives me. He blesses me every day. Every morning that I wake up, it's a blessing. Every breath that I take, it's a blessing. He's letting me live another day, another hour, another minute, another second. Christians are going to be the happiest people on earth. When you look back, when you try to count all the blessings, you're so happy to live. How can you not be a happy? God has let you be a father. God has let you be a mother. And you raised your children to the best of your ability. That's a blessing to be able to raise a child and bring it up in the right way. That's a blessing. But the parents do that now? Parents just send them out on the street because they don't want food at the moment. That's what's wrong with America. That's what's wrong with this nation and this world. People get a gift from God and they don't even know how to take care of it. They don't want to be burdened taking care of a child. So they just send them out on the street and do for themselves. And what are they going to do on the street?
they're gonna learn from other people and stuff. They're not gonna learn from mom and dad what's right and what's wrong. Mom and dad, in this day and age, they're sending their kids to hell because they won't keep them at home and tell them about Jesus Christ. Nine times out of ten, mom and dad don't even know about Jesus Christ. That's the reason the kids are out on the street. Because if they had Jesus in their heart, they would love their children. Them children wouldn't be a burden to them. They would be teaching those children about Jesus Christ, about doing right and staying away from things that are wrong. God loves us. He don't want to see none of us end up in hell. Like I said, that's our own choice. God gives us the free will either to accept Him or reject Him. But that's going to soon end, because the day of the Lord is going to be upon us. He's going to destroy this earth as we know it. I think they call that the Battle of Armageddon. God's going to destroy it. He's going to destroy Satan and all his demons. There's going to be some miracles performed like we've never seen. But in a twinkling of an eye, I bet people change the earth to be who we were. After He destroys the earth that we know. How many times has God tugged at your heart? How many times has He sent conviction upon you? And you just said, don't do a thing. I don't see how anybody. I know I couldn't, when I was under conviction, I couldn't wait for all the time. But if there's ever anybody in this church that's under conviction, I want them to know this altar is always open. You don't have to wait for an altar call. If God's dealing with your heart, you get up and you come to this altar. There'll be somebody here to pray with you. I know I'll be there to pray with you. There is nothing. I've got it on Facebook. There is nothing I want to see more than somebody walk the aisle and ask Jesus Christ into their heart. That's my heart's desire, to see people saved. If we all had that desire to see people saved, I believe this church would start growing. Examine your heart. Do you want to see people get saved? Do you want to see this church grow? I wish every Sunday we had to put out chairs. I wish we had to go to Walmart and buy some more chairs, but we didn't have them yet. I'd like to open up the window and put chairs outside for people to sit in. Put speakers out on the porch so they can hear. Because God loves each and every person in this world. He don't want to see nobody die and go to hell.
I don't want to see nobody die and go to hell. The hardest funeral to preach is for somebody that you never know of them going to church. You never know of them accepting Jesus Christ. They may have. But if you don't know they have, that is a hard thing to preach. You can't find words to comfort the family when you have no recollection of the person laying down in that casket ever asking God to come into your life. I like the old saying, a person preaches his own view while he's living. I believe if anybody in this church died, it'd be easy to preach your view. Because you've already preached your funeral while you're living. By how you treat people. By showing your love for God and your love for family, your love for your church. Christian people have something that lost people don't know about. Lost people has no idea what love is until they accept Jesus Christ and feel the greatest love of all, the love of Jesus. Yeah. I wish I had the words in me to scare everybody to want to know Jesus Christ. But that ain't the way God works. You can't scare people into becoming a Christian. You've got to show them love. The love of Jesus. The greatest love ever was. The greatest love they ever will be. It's the love that Jesus has for his children. I'm thankful that I know that the day of the Lord is coming. Even though it's going to be a terrible day for those lost, I'm looking forward to it. Because when we get into that new heaven and that new earth, no more trouble, no more heartache, no more sickness, no more death. Everybody's going to be at harmony. Ain't going to be no backbiting. Ain't nobody going to say something to you. It's going to crawl under your skin and make you mad. Everybody is going to be perfect the way Jesus is perfect, the way God's perfect. I'm looking forward to that day when Jesus returns. And I'm looking for the day when, whenever it may be the same day, it may be 7 years after, but I'm looking for the day of the Lord. Everything. So we know that it's done away with. And we're all going to be in perfect peace and harmony with each other. Jesus, mom and dad, brothers and sisters, family. Saved. No more tears.
more catch. No more days of getting up with your back aching, with your legs aching, with your arms aching, your shoulders, whatever. Different people have different ailments. All that's going to be done away with. No more hearing aids. No more crutches. No more wheelchairs. We're going to be living in eternal peace and love forever and ever. For the ones watching on YouTube, by the way, YouTube let me back on this past week. I prayed about it, prayed about it, prayed about it. I hit the glass Saturday night singing, and it was later just like the spoken. I hit it to Sunday morning service, and it was later just like the spoken. Satan was defeated. Praise God. For the ones who are watching on Facebook, YouTube, today is the day of salvation. And there's no better time to come to the Lord. There's 3 hours. You can have salvation. It's free. It was paid for at Calvary. And Jesus hung on the cross. He died for our sins so that we could have and we have life. Today is the day of salvation. The day of the Lord is nigh upon us. And there's not going to be any more sin. All of our chances are going to vanish. We will either be in heaven or we will be in heaven. And it's your choice. Where do you want to spend eternity? Heaven or hell? Somebody said, well, that's all you have preached about. God put a desire in my heart to see people saved. And as long as that desire is in my heart to see people saved, that's what I'm going to preach. Unless God gives me something else. And as long as he tells me to preach, in heaven or hell, that's what I'm going to preach. But I want to see, I don't want to see nobody go to hell. If it's up to me, I just save everybody to be over with. But it's not up to me. I'm not God. I don't want to be God. Because if I was God, I'm sure somewhere along the line I would make a mistake. I don't even want to play God. But I do desire to see this world come to know Jesus. This nation, our government leaders, I desire to see him saved. That's the message.